Why do Hindus worship idols? You must have heard this from many people. Some people say it is not good to worship idols because they believe Ishwara has no image. For a moment, this argument seems to be logical, but if you think deeply, you will get solid reasons behind this ancient practice. I am going to tell you about the real purpose of this ancient practice of worshipping idols in Hinduism. First, let me tell you that worshipping is not about offering something to a deity or praying to the deity. It is about concentrating on the deity or anything you want to worship. Concentrating on anything means what? Let me give you an example. If you concentrate on a human being, what will happen to you? And if you concentrate on a tree, what will happen to you? In both cases, your senses will be focusing on a particular object. It means your mind will remain stable and your senses will not get distracted. You will turn inward and experience your inner energy. In Hinduism, it is called Bhakti Yoga, as the mind and body coordinate with each other in devotion. There are different ways to worship or perform this yoga in Hinduism. We know by nature the human mind is fickle. Therefore, self-realization is very difficult for us. Because we are attached to the material world, we cannot focus on something that is beyond the material world. The Brahma Tattva that is beyond the material world is considered to be the supreme thing in Hinduism. It is present everywhere. It is the material within the universe and the universe as well. So by knowledge, it cannot be understood. As you know, it appears with their dual nature to our intellect. So we must experience it by becoming one with it. And how can that be achieved? It is only by concentrating on it. By concentrating on the Brahma Tattva, we'll dissolve our egos and on all unrealistic attachments into itself. But you may ask, where is the Brahma Tattva? Well, it is everywhere. So if you concentrate on a rock, you concentrate on Brahma. If you concentrate on a tree, river, planet, animal, you ultimately concentrate on Brahma Tattva. Because everything is Brahma Tattva. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says in chapter 13, sloka 28, that when he sees the Brahma Tattva Ishwara abiding everywhere alike, he does not himself hurt by himself. And hence, he attains the supreme goal. But there are some beings who do not live in attachments like the sannyasis or the yogis. They do not need to follow the practice of worshipping murtis and trees, rivers and planets, because they have realized they just worship the Brahma Tattva inside themselves by meditating upon themselves. But everyone cannot be like them, because most people have families, friends and other responsibilities in this world. So they cannot just simply draw their senses inward and try to experience the Brahma Tattva. How can it be possible even? For example, if a person who lives in a luxurious house has many cars and all materialistic pleasure, can he leave these attachments and turn inward easily? I think it is not possible. So for them, the easiest way is to experience Brahma Tattva through materials or objects, because they identify better with the objects and materials. But the goal is the same. The goal of a yogi and the goal of a bhogi are same, because the yogi experiences Brahma Tattva by going inward, and we or the people who live in attachment will also experience the same by going outward or worshipping anything we want. Once you start worshipping a murti or a rock, it actually becomes a vigraha. It doesn't remain murti because you give life to it, or you do pran pratishta. You just don't need to follow the rituals. Once you start worshipping it, for you it becomes a vigraha, because you make it a deity. So basically, this is the concept of worshipping murtis, trees, animals, and all type of objects. So Hindus not only worship murtis, but they also worship everything, because that is the spiritual science that tells that Brahma is everywhere and everything you see in this universe is Brahma Tattva.